So the National Social Security Fund is seeking to increase compliance amongst employers, and this is because there is a huge concern. Now, just 11% of employees have their remittances sent to NSSF every month, and yet the fund is targeting over 50% by 2035. This sounds like a huge target, but they are looking to use what they've called a revamped whistleblower platform that should help you report your employer, and it will be an anonymous platform. Trust me, no one will know what you are doing or who you are reporting. This has been revamped, and the fund believes if well used, they could record huge sums. Currently, about 8.9 billion has been recovered from such employers that are not paying money for their employees. And also, civil society organizations are concerned about what they call, if government is to help with the energy transition conversation, then there must be deliberate funding allocated to this sector. That is something we wait to see, and it's just part of the conversations that are going on in the world of business this week. Thank you so much for joining us on the show. My name is Simon. From wherever you're watching, we're glad you could make time. This is what's coming up on the Business Show this week.
So you can progress. What keeps you just in one location is because you've not thought about what else to do. Are you progressing at the correct speed in what you are doing? Is it giving you enough financial returns? What about your own self-actualization? Are you feeling satisfied with the work you are doing? Think outside the box and see what else can you do.
Welcome to the show, and this week we'll start with Views from the Top. And shea butter production is something that maybe you would say is not really so, you know, a big deal in Uganda, or it's not a popular production kind of thing you'd say, but there is actually a business around it. Of course, most of it is done in northern part of the country, but experts are saying there is a need to encourage more people to engage in its production because the demand is available. The market is right there, not just in Uganda, but even across the region. This week on Views from the Top, we want to speak to Claudia, who is a project manager at Your Will, who talks to us about the project they are spearheading to encourage more people in the northern part of the country to grow shea butter, plus also the issue of quality and quantity in production. This is Views from the Top.
Claudia Tusingwile, and I work with UWILL, Uganda Women Entrepreneurs Association Limited, on one of the projects that is aiming at transforming the lives of men and women involved in the shea value chain in northern Uganda.
So I know for a fact that this project has been running for close to a year and 6 months now. Maybe first of all, why did we choose to deal in shea butter of all commodities?
Okay, UWILL chose to deal with the shea value chain because of the problems that we realize that are affecting the women and men's lives that are benefiting from the shea value chain, first of all. The sector itself is not organized, and people collect nuts as individuals and sell the nuts and shea butter as individuals. So in the process, they end up losing the benefits they would be enjoying in terms of getting a good price for their shea nuts. Secondly, the sector also does not have enough information on issues of post-harvest handling. basically pest harvest handling, when we talk of that, we mean how to harvest the shea nuts, sorting, drying, storage, and packaging. So we realized there are bad practices in post-harvest handling, and we managed to secure this project, which is funded by East African Women in Business Platform, based in Tanzania, from our partners as well, Enhanced Integrated Framework, that is EIF is the donor, passing the money through the East African Business Platform in Tanzania. So it is a kind of multidisciplinary project. We are working with different partners. And this project is also operating in South Sudan. So we have South Sudan Women Entrepreneurs Association on board as well.
Okay.
So we work with them, and they are also developing the shea value chain within South Sudan.
Okay. Yeah. So coming to the next 6 months, which should be then having the project close, maybe the first question then would be, what impact from the things you've mentioned, you know, the market, I mean, the sector not being organized, the dealers being cheated because they sell as individuals. What impact has this project created in the value chain?
Okay, the project, first of all, it has trained over 2,200 individuals, both in Uganda and South Sudan, in cooperative formation. We have helped the communities that we have dealt with to form cooperatives, and in case of Uganda, we are in 24 districts across the shea belt, and so far we have 10 cooperatives formed in the different districts. We have also trained 4,160 individuals in issues of post-harvest handling, how to sort the nuts, removing the bad ones from the good ones, how to store the nuts so that they remain with good conditions, and how to build a shea business. The project is also in the process of constructing a shea processing facility in one of the districts that will be probably chosen. Maybe we are looking at either Kitugum or Agago district, which is in Achoi sub-region, and this facility will enable women who are mainly the majority who dominate the shea value chain, especially in collecting the nuts and processing, to get access to technology that will enable them to produce good shea butter that is at international standards. That is, we call it cold-pressed shea butter.
Okay. So you talk about international standards, and I'm just thinking, just of what importance, or where do you think generally as a country we stand when you talk about shea butter, and do you think we have utilized the available avenues to boost on the production of shea butter and also value addition and then export?
Okay, as a nation, we are blessed to have shea nilotica, which is known for Uganda or East Africa. And the government is generating good revenue in form of foreign exchange through exports of shea butter. And a good number of women and men, they have ventured into shea processing. They have different processing facilities, and they are able to export as individuals. And that one attracts foreign exchange as well as getting income for the individuals involved. However, the sector, as I had earlier said, it is not yet well organized. And majority of the entrepreneurs who are involved in shea butter trade, they do not know where to sell, looking for markets. The market is there.
Yes.
And the value of the shea nilotica that we have, it is known internationally, it is a good kind of shea butter for cosmetics and pharmaceuticals. Mm. But Uganda has not yet positioned itself very well to reap from this sector.
Okay. And you know, when you talk about the fact that we have not positioned ourselves well to reap from the sector, but also the fact that most of the people dealing in this particular product are women, maybe does that then talk to us about what it means to operate in a formal system, formal kind of trading, where, you know, like you say, don't have all the right structures? Is that something you want to speak to?
I would say that the value chain for any commodity, it has to look at issues of production, policy, and regulations, then quality and standards. Mm. So to tap into the international market, you have to have all those aspects intertwined together and worked on. Mm. So yes, we have, for instance, we have the national shea butter strategy, which guides on export aspects of how to prepare yourself to export shea butter. But we do not have a policy yet or a law that is working on protection. At the same time, we do not have the shea population, shea tree population. So at times when a trader or an entrepreneur in shea butter is trying to look for the markets, the intending company to import from Uganda's shea butter will ask you issues of sustainability. How many shea trees? If I give you a contract, how will you be able to give me the supply for how long? So you find in most cases they are asking for the shea statistics. How many shea trees do you get this shea butter? So in that case, we are missing as a country because we don't have statistics about the shea trees that we have in the country, so that we are able to value how much we can supply in terms of production.
Okay. As we come to the end of this discussion or this conversation, really, the question would be, so you have formed or you've helped these women and men form cooperatives. So what next?
What next? You know, Rome was not built in one day. Mm. So at least this project has done what we call preparatory and eye-opening on the shea benefits and value for the communities. At least now there has been increased awareness on the benefits of the shea value, why we need to protect this, how we need to handle the processes. So we hope in the next few years Uganda, we are positioning ourselves to be better suppliers of shea nilotica as one of the raw materials to add value.
All right, great conversation there coming in from Claudia. And like I've always said on this program, if we are going to encourage farmers or generally people in the production space to meet the demands across the market, then we are going to work in cooperatives or associations, because these then allow us to produce for the bigger market. If a guy at point A has 20 tons and a guy at point B has 10 or 15 tons, then we have to add up this and, you know, make up on the numbers to meet the demands on the market. I keep saying we do not have to work in silos. I don't understand why one person should fail the entire market just because they cannot meet the demands that are asked out there by the different consumers. Okay? The debate on AGOA still goes on. Should we, shouldn't we? Is the expansion any good? I tell you what, CASITA members are up in arms and they're saying the government needs to do something. I'll tell you more about that. For now, let's take a quick break on the program. Stay with us. And in the meantime, feel free to get in touch with us. I'll see you shortly.